making it a crime, punishable by at least 5 years in jail, if you knowingly sell this stuff to somebody and they overdose and die. Treat it the same way we treat manslaughter. If you drive a car, you crash into somebody else, you're culpable. We should be treating this stuff the same way and put some real pressure on the traffickers and the dealers who are out there not caring about who they kill or who dies as a result of what they're up to, and make them pay the price that they should pay for knowingly engaging in this type of activity.
And that's why in this bill, thanks to the leadership of Secretary Bennett, we are able to address two specific points. One of them is relative to witness intimidation and protection. And what it can do is expand a law that was passed back in 2006. And while intimidating a witness is a felony in Massachusetts, as it should be, it was not clear in the law that was passed how far that protection goes. And this bill will now make it such that witnesses and their family members will be protected under the Witness Intimidation Act. This will also help in terms of solicitation to commit a felony. And this is what's known as murder for hire. In most states, murder for hire is in and of itself a serious enough crime to be punishable by a prison sentence, including up to 30 years in other states in New England, like Maine and New Hampshire. But here, it's just a misdemeanor.
The governor's bill offers what we view as straightforward and effective solutions to address several gaps existing in current legislation that adversely affect the people of this Commonwealth every day.
I want to thank the governor for his leadership and his courage in taking on such a big issue that many might have thought was unsolvable. But his leadership is showing us that we solve it one bite at a time. You know, we take it one bite at a time. And I want to thank the Lieutenant Governor for her leadership and her compassion for those of us who have lost loved ones to violence and those of us that are standing on the front lines and working with law enforcement. I'm very grateful for the community policing and the partnerships that we've been able to form along the way, and the Secretary for his leadership and introducing this bill. And why is all of this so important to us? The importance is that, you know, grief never goes away. But one of the things that help us to move into and move forward is having that murder solved. And many times we hear from law enforcement that, you know, they know who committed the crime, but no one wants to come forward. No one wants to say anything because they don't feel safe. And introducing this bill sends a message to all of the communities who are being impacted by violence, who are dealing with, you know, with the opium crisis, who are dealing with all of this, because it's all relative. It sends a message that we're not alone, that there's laws being passed that will be enforced that will sentence those individuals that are committing crimes against innocent citizens to jail. And if you intimidate them along the way as they're exercising, you know, their civic leadership duty, then you're going to go to jail.
The worst day of my life was December 31st, 2008, where I received a call saying that my son was hurt on public transportation. Now, when you hear public transportation in 2008, you never expect for a killing because it's public transportation. There's a lot of people on there, so, you know, somebody should see something. Well, my son was stabbed to death on a number 28 bus on New Year's Eve. He was 16 years old. And no one has come forward to solve this case. There are many people that was on the bus, and there are some that did see, but I can't blame these people because they're just so scared that they don't want these goons to come after them as well and scare their families. I would like this bill to protect the witnesses. We have to protect our witnesses. If we don't protect our witnesses, our stuff is going to go unsolved.
So as the City of Quincy Substance Use Prevention Coordinator and a former assistant district attorney assigned to the specialty court, specifically my heart was really in drug court, this bill recognizes that all of those suffering from opiate addiction and other substances matter. And it sends a strong message that anyone who intentionally harms them deserves to be punished. This is truly a step in taking the stigma away. It tells drug dealers that when they're selling drugs to people in the most vulnerable state of their illness, it's not okay. Because despite what they may think, those people matter. I'd like to applaud the governor, lieutenant governor, and secretary for this forward-thinking language of this bill. I know it's scary to think that things can get worse, but the governor is facing the very real chance that stronger drugs will begin to appear and proactively setting us up to enforce laws against them and save lives. So, Danny, I will no longer tell people immediately all of the great things you were. Instead, I'll honestly let them know that my brother died of a heroin overdose. But above all else, you were and are so loved. Thank you. Amen.